So let's talk about Cilium Egress Gateway, and in particular, Cilium Egress Gateway High Availability. So what is this? The Egress Gateway feature in Cilium was introduced in Cilium 1.10. And the goal is to allow to redirect traffic from specific pods to specific ciders outside of the cluster so that they're routed through specific nodes of the cluster. So when the Egress Gateway feature is activated in a cluster, is enabled, then you can use specific resources called egress NAT policies. And these egress NAT policies will allow you to specify how to route the packets outside the cluster so that they are actually masqueraded with selected predictable IPs associated to these egress nodes. So what you need in order to use this feature is first, you need network-facing interfaces and IP addresses on the nodes that will work as egress nodes. You need masquerading activated, available in your kernel with eBPF. And you need kubeproxy replacement enabled in your Cilium configuration. Once you have this, you can get started with Egress Gateway. So what does it look like actually? We have some pods here on a worker node in the cluster. And we have a node that we've identified as an Egress Gateway node. And in Kubernetes, we have set up an Egress NAT policy that says that for this pod, To access a CIDR outside the cluster, where typically we have a legacy database, for example, then it needs to go through this Egress Gateway node. So when the pod is trying to reach out to this IP here, 10.24.0.5, the Cilium agent on the node will know that it needs to route it through the Egress node. So it will send the traffic to the Egress Gateway node, and the Egress Gateway node will know that the traffic comes from the pod, will know to apply the egress NAT policy, and it will masquerade the IP by replacing the source IP of the pod with the source IP that is specified, either the interface and it will look up the IP, or the IP itself can be specified in the NAT policy, and then it will send the traffic to legacy DB. And when, obviously, when it returns, when the traffic returns, it will be written back to send it back to the pod. So what does it look like in Kubernetes? The resources looks like this. And this is the open source version, and we can specify how to select the pod. So here we have a pod that matches the labels app equals test app. So for this pod, reaching out to this CIDR, we want to go out through this IP, and Cilium will figure out how to reach, how to use this IP, how to select the nodes to exit the cluster. This makes it very easy to filter out IPs going out of the cluster when you need to filter out using traditional firewalls, for example, in your infrastructure. Now, what we're going to talk about here is the specific high availability version of this Egress Gateway feature, which is available in Cilium Enterprise. So in Cilium Enterprise, what we have is we have the ability to specify actually several nodes here. So here we have three nodes for a NAT policy. So if a node fails, the traffic will keep going through the other nodes. And when the nodes are not failing, the traffic will actually be load balanced between the three nodes. So I have a little demo to show you. It will look like this. This is the NAT policy I will use with the destination CIDR here. So when the pod that is specified here, the pod has a label app/io/name equals egress gateway monitor in this namespace. And when this pod is trying to reach this destination CIDR, it should go through one of these nodes. I actually have four nodes, but it takes too much space. We get the idea. We've got some egress IPs here and the zones in which they are located on Amazon. This is an Amazon Web Services demo. So let's look at the demo itself. We're going to have a monitor application here, which is not part of Cilium. It's just a pod running in the cluster. It happens to be in zone D of my VPC here. And this monitor will send HTTP requests to an echo server that will return the IP that the requests are coming from, so we can see where it comes from. And it will be load balanced over the four egress nodes here. So let's quickly look at the demo here. So I've got here the monitor that is running, and we can see the logs. And we see that the requests are going and returning the IP. I'll stop it a bit here. Returning the IPs, and we can see that it's going through the four different IPs. I'm actually collecting metrics for this pod and displaying them in Grafana here. We can see that it's clearly load balanced. The requests are going through the four different IPs, so exiting through four different nodes. And for a total of almost 20 requests per second. We get 5 requests per second going through each node. The load times are a little bit different per node. That's because some nodes are located in the same availability zone as the monitor pod or as the echo server, while other nodes are located in the other availability zone. So it's a little bit further. There's a hop through another availability zone. And what we see here, I can stop here for a minute, is the Cilium BPF egress list comment running on the Cilium agent where the monitor pod is running. And we see that Cilium knows that it needs to route this the traffic coming from this IP, from this pod, to this CIDR through one of these 4 nodes. So what happens now, I'm just gonna show you quickly. If I reboot a node, I'm gonna choose the node that is running in zone A here, and I will reboot it. There you go. Let's reboot it. And very quickly, Cilium should figure out that the node is down when it comes down. See here, the node is down. Cilium takes it out of the load balancing, and we actually lose some connections. It's expected, right? Before Cilium finds out that the node is down, because we haven't told Cilium that the node was going down. So here it started at 10:58 towards the beginning of the 58 second, and all the way to 10:59 towards the end. So 2 seconds. So for 2 seconds, Cilium is finding out that the node is gone and rerouting the traffic. So before it was going down, the traffic was successfully going through this node, which is 210. And after, it's not going through this node anymore. We don't see any green anymore, but instead it's going through the 3 other nodes. And now we see in Grafana how the traffic is being load balanced again. There's still a little bit here. That's Grafana updating. It's got a rate over 1 minute, but it will quickly show the proper results here. The node should be coming back up. We can keep looking at this. So again, this feature would allow us here to typically set, let's say the echo server instead was a database and we wanted to filter out the IPs coming out of the cluster, we could typically set a firewall and say, I know exactly which IPs are coming out of the cluster to this database, so I can filter out by IP to control the traffic coming out.